It was all about religion. What to do, what to say, what to wear on a Sunday. All about perfection. Black and white, wrong or right, never gray. I'd never make it. I'd never be good enough. I tried to walk the line, pray that I'd find something that I knew was real. Began to realize the harder I tried, the colder I'd start to feel. Until the moment, the second I met your love. And then I threw my hands up, worries down. I remember when he showed me how to break up with my doubt. Once I was lost, but now I'm found. No strings attached when he saved my soul. He is more than just a rescue, that's where it starts, not where it ends. Let freedom in, more than just a story in the sky, where and why. He's alive in every moment. And now that I know this love, I can throw my hands up, worries down. I remember when he showed me how to break up with my doubt. Once I was lost, but now I'm found. No strings attached when he saved my soul. Want you to know. The words I'm waiting for, it came alive when I let go. All I had was a broken heart, then he held me in his arms. You're the words I'm waiting for, I came alive when I let go. All I had was a broken heart, then he held me in. I can throw my hands up, worries down. I remember when he showed me how to break up with my doubt. Once I was lost, but now then he held me in his arms. Darkened shadows round me creep, knowing I awaken nevermore to roam. Anywhere with Jesus will be home, sweet home. Anywhere, anywhere, any little fear I'll never know. Anywhere with Jesus I can safely go. Anywhere with Jesus I can surely go.
Good morning, church. The Lord be with you. Thank you. It is good to be together in his house. I'm struck by that second song, though, in that line where it says, anywhere with Jesus I can go to sleep. Hoping that you don't this morning. Welcome to guests and visitors, sincerely. We're here for God's word and sacrament. We'll start in just a moment with the Blessed Sacrament of Baptism for Cohen Dean Willenberg. And I ask you to turn to page 268 in your hymnal so that you can follow along and be a part of that sacrament where God works through word and water. Our Operation Christmas Child boxes are due today out there in the atrium. Thanks for your responses so far. Our Haiti Hunger Fight fundraising meal is right after this service in the gymnasium, and I hope that you'll stay and be a part of that and learn and be inspired and be, if God blesses you and you're able, be generous so that we can, in mercy, share what we have with children and families in Haiti. Sign up for the Golden Eagles meals coming up. Well, today is the due date for that, for this month's meal, so please sign up today. And after service, I'm going to be at the back door and make sure that you take home one of these. And if you happen to go out the side door, you can still take one because there's a whole stack of them on the second pew right by the elevator. Take home this devotional booklet. It's called Behold the Child. This will be our theme all of Advent and Christmas. And Advent starts just 2 weeks from today. It is a time to keep Christ at the center of Advent and Christmas, in church and at home. So God bless these devotions. Take them home, and if you want to, take one so that you can give one to somebody that you want to invite to worship this morning. I'd ask you please to turn to page 268 in your bulletin, and we will walk through the good gift of baptism. I'd ask now that Cohen's family would join me here at the font, and we would gather around, bring a hymnal up with you. You've already started to do that. The font will get uncovered, and God works through this little bit of water and through the power of his word. Page 268. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dearly beloved, Christ our Lord says in the last chapter of Matthew, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. In the last chapter of Mark, our Lord promises, whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. And the Apostle Peter has written, baptism now saves you. The Word of God also teaches that we're all conceived and born sinful and are under the power of the devil until Christ claims us as his own. We would be lost forever unless delivered from sin, death, and everlasting condemnation. But the Father of all mercy and grace has sent his Son, Jesus Christ, who atoned for the sin of the whole world, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. Bailey and Kyle, how is your son to be named? Cohen Dean Willenberg.
Receive the sign of the cross both upon your forehead and upon your heart to mark you as one redeemed by Christ the crucified. Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, according to your strict judgment, you condemn the unbelieving world through the flood. And yet, according to your great mercy, you preserved believing Noah and his family, 8 souls in all. You drowned hard-hearted Pharaoh and all of his host in the Red Sea. And yet you led your people Israel through the water and dry ground, foreshadowing this washing of your holy baptism. Through the baptism in the Jordan of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, you sanctified and instituted all waters to be a blessed flood and a lavish washing away of sin. We pray that you would behold Cohen according to your boundless mercy and bless him with true faith by the Holy Spirit, that through this saving flood, all sin in him which has been inherited from Adam and which he himself has committed since would be drowned and die. Grant that he be kept safe and secure in the holy ark of the Christian church, being separated from the multitude of unbelievers and serving your name at all times with a fervent spirit and a joyful hope, so that with all believers in your promise, he would be declared worthy of eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Sponsors and witnesses have an important work as you assist Cohen's family in keeping the faith. From ancient times, the church has observed the custom of appointing sponsors for baptismal candidates and catechumens. In the Evangelical Lutheran Church, sponsors are to confess the faith expressed in the Apostles' Creed and taught in the Small Catechism. They are, whenever possible, to witness the baptism of those that they sponsor. They're to pray for them, support them in their ongoing instruction and nurture in the Christian faith, and encourage them toward the faithful reception of the Lord's Supper. They're at all times to be examples to them of the holy life of faith in Christ and love for the neighbor. Is it your intention to serve Cohen as his sponsors and witnesses in the Christian faith? If so, say yes with the help of God. God enable you both to will and to do this faithful and loving work, and with his grace fulfill what we're really unable to do. Amen. Hear the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The disciples brought young children to Jesus that he might touch them, but the disciples rebuked them. When Jesus saw it, he was greatly displeased, and he said to them, "Let the little children come to me. Do not forbid them, for of such is the kingdom of God. Assuredly, I say to you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God like a little child will by no means enter it." And he took them up in his arms. Jesus put his hands on them and blessed them. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Congregation can remain seated as we pray the family prayer of the church. Together we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The Lord preserve your coming in and your going out from this time forth and even forevermore. Amen. Because Cohen cannot yet answer for himself, his family and his church family will answer on his behalf these important questions of renouncing and believing. Cohen, do you renounce the devil? Yes, I renounce it. Do you renounce all his works?
Yes, I renounce it.
And do you renounce all his ways?
Yes, I renounce it.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth?
Yes, I believe.
And do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried? He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. And do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Yes,
I believe. Kyle and Bailey, do you desire your son to be baptized? Cohen, Dean, Willenberg, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And God's people say, Amen. And so does he. The Almighty God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given you new birth of water and of the Spirit and has forgiven you all your sins, strengthen you with his grace to life everlasting. Amen. The white garment, please. Thank you. I know he's all well. Good catch, Mom. Good catch. I know he's already wearing white, but here's a symbolic little garment that we place upon the child. Receive this white garment to show that you've been clothed with the robe of Christ's righteousness that covers all of your sin. So you will stand before him in the judgment seat of Christ to receive the inheritance that's been prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Kyle, would you go up and light that little candle that's on the altar? We're going to leave it there on the altar during the service, and we hope you'll take this home, and each year on November 17th, you'll have another candle to light, as this is symbolic of the light that is in us for Christ's sake and by his work. Kyle knows that it's kind of hard to get it to stand up, but you accomplished it. Cohen, receive this burning light to show that you have received Christ, who is the light of the world. Live always in the light of Christ and be ever watchful for his coming, that you may meet him with joy and enter with him in the marriage feast of the Lamb in his kingdom, which has no end. Hear the good news and welcome him. In holy baptism, God the Father has made Cohen Dean Willenberg a member of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and an heir with us of all the treasures of heaven in the Holy Christian and Apostolic Church. We receive you in Jesus' name as our brother in Christ, that together we might hear his word, receive his gifts, and proclaim the praises of him who called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. Amen. We welcome you in the name of the Lord. Let us pray. Almighty and most merciful God and Father, we thank and praise you that you graciously preserve and enlarge your family and have granted this boy the new birth in holy baptism and have made him a member of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and an heir of your heavenly kingdom. We humbly implore you, as Cohen has now become your child, you would keep him in his baptismal grace, that according to your good pleasure, he will faithfully grow to lead a godly life to the praise and honor of your holy name. And finally, with all your saints, obtain the promised inheritance in heaven through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Cohen, Dean, Jesus, bless and be with you with his peace. God's people say, Amen. So what I'd like you to do, as we hear a little bit of the hymn, I am Jesus' little lamb. Well, I'll get that one. Walk down the center aisle and show the congregation, please, the newest member of the body of Christ of St. John's Lutheran Church. He is, by God's grace, Jesus' little lamb. Both of you can walk down, or all three of you can walk down there. And you can give that to them afterwards.
Congregation, let's stand together to sing the first song, I Can Only Imagine.
I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? To my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine when that day comes, when I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I will do is forever worship you. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? Or to my knees? I can only imagine.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
When many say, the time is at hand, do not go after them. When you hear of wars and tumults, do not be afraid. When you are brought before kings and governors for my name's sake, I will give you a mouth and wisdom. When these things begin to take place, straighten up and raise your heads, because your redemption is drawing near. Looking toward Jesus' return in judgment and the gracious gift of his own righteousness, let us confess our sins to God, our Father. Most merciful God, we confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in our thoughts, words, and actions. We are bound to sin without your forgiveness and help. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will this day and walk in your ways until the dawning of the day of your return. Amen. Sisters and brothers in Christ, before we were born, Almighty God gave His Son to die for you. He is the Son of Righteousness. Because of your baptism into the death and resurrection of Christ, each day He declares you righteous for Jesus' sake. And when our Lord returns, we shall go out leaping like calves from the stall. As a called and ordained servant of Christ and by His authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. O Lord, almighty and ever-living God, you have given exceedingly great and precious promises to those who trust in you. Rule and govern our hearts and minds by your Holy Spirit, that we may live and abide forever in your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You can be seated, please, to hear the word of the Lord, beginning with Malachi chapter 4.
For behold, the day is coming, burning like an oven, when all the arrogant and all evildoers will be stubble. The day that is coming shall set them ablaze, says the Lord of hosts, so that it will leave them neither root nor branch. But for you who fear my name, the Son of Righteousness shall rise with healing in its wings. You shall go out leaping like calves from the stall, and you shall tread down the wicked, for they will be ashes under the soles of your feet, on the day when I act, says the Lord of hosts. Remember the law of my servant Moses, the statutes and rules that I commanded him at Horeb for all Israel. Behold, I will send you Elijah, the prophet, before the great and awesome day of the Lord comes. And he will turn the hearts of fathers to their children and the hearts of children to their fathers, lest I come and strike the land with a decree of utter destruction. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Kids, come up for a brief children's sermon. Come up and join me here, sitting on the communion pads. Come on up, boys and girls. We'll sit across the front here. And I've got something moms and dads and grandmas and grandpas to do, too. And you guys can sit anywhere in there. That's fine. Sit down right there on the steps. Good, good. Keep coming. Some people can sit out here if you want to. Anywhere up in there is okay. Eyes up here and ears open. First thing, I'd love you to respond to me. Can you, Elijah, can you sit down over there a little bit, please? Everybody looking up here, you ready? Good morning. That was pretty good. It's good to see you and hear you in church this morning. Raise your hand if you like to play games. What are some of the games that you like to play? Anybody want to name one? Did somebody say sorry? Okay, and what else? Board games, like big long games like Monopoly even? Long games like that? I'm impressed. What else? Candyland. That's another board game. What else? Pokemon is a very popular gift, or game. How about this one? See if you can finish the name of it. Hide and... Yeah, you knew that one, right? I wonder if Jesus played hide and seek. I think that game has been around that long, that when Jesus played with his friends when he was a little boy, maybe he played hide and seek. 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 What does that word mean? What is seeking? You find something or someone, right? Dads and moms work so that they can seek making a living and keep the family going. We're going to sing a song in just a little bit. It's called Seek Ye First. Congregation, you can turn to hymn 712. 712, I'll play that on my guitar in just a little bit, and you'll sing it with your kids in the pew. Seek ye first. The little word ye means you. You can seek. You can go looking for God's kingdom. God's kingdom first in your life. I asked you about games. Now, raise your hand if you like food. Yeah, me too. What kind of food do you like? What one? Yes? Keep going. Hot dogs. What is it, Mexican? Yes, I'm with you. You like hot dogs too? Everybody has a favorite food. Does anybody like bread? Do you know what? I had somebody in first service who said, I don't like bread, but I like sausages. I do too. Here's why I'm bringing that up. In the hymn that you're about to sing back in the pew with mom and dad or grandma and grandpa, the third verse says, I know, I know. And the third verse says, man does not live. People don't live just by bread or sausages or any other kind of food. We don't just live by that. We live by the Word of God. That is the most important thing in our life. Dads and moms and leaders of families are to lead their families in ways so that the kingdom of God is first. So today, you're going to finish the children's sermon back out there in the pew. And I'm hoping that your mom and dad sit next to you and look at this hymn and show you where we are. Even if you're not a reader yet, you can sing two of the words that get repeated a lot in this. Alleluia, alleluia. It means praise God. He sought us out and He bought you. He loves you. Walk back, sit in the pews with grandmas and grandpas and moms and dads and sing this song with them and with the whole church. Seek ye first, sorry Maddie, seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, so that we're in the Word all week. I need to lay this hymnal out here so that I can find and lead the words. Hymn 712. Help the kids to sing this too. Thanks, got it. Jeff, I think I need to use your guitar because mine went terribly out of tune, or I need you to play it. Can I trade with you? Because you can just set that aside. Thank you. Because somehow between first and second service, it changed in a very, very big way. Much better. Thank you. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Alleluia, alleluia. Ask and it shall be given unto you. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and the door shall be opened unto you. Alleluia, alleluia. Man does not live by bread alone, but by every we don't live by mere bread, but by the Word of God. And we'll keep on listening to the word that gives life. Thank you, Nancy. Go ahead.
The epistle reading this morning is from 2 Thessalonians chapter 3, verses 1 to 13. Finally, brothers, pray for us that the word of the Lord may speed ahead and be honored, as happened among you, and that we may be delivered from wicked and evil men. For not all have faith, but the Lord is faithful. He will establish you and guard you against the evil one. And we have confidence in the Lord about you, that you are doing and will do the things that we command. May the Lord direct your hearts to the love of God and to the steadfastness of Christ. Now we command you, brothers, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that you keep away from any brother who is walking in idleness and not in accord with the tradition that you received from us. For you yourselves know how you ought to imitate us, because we were not idle when we were with you, nor did we eat anyone's bread without paying for it. But with toil and labor we worked night and day, that we may not be a burden to any of you. It was not because we do not have that right, but to give you in ourselves an example to imitate. For even when we were with you, we would give you this command: if anyone is not willing to work, let him not eat. For we hear that some among you walk in idleness, not busy at work, but busybodies. Now such persons we command and encourage in the Lord Jesus Christ to do their work quietly and to earn their own living. As for you, brothers, do not grow weary in doing good. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Redeems us. God's mercy shall never end.
Stand, please. The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the 21st chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. And while some were speaking of the temple, how it was adorned with noble stones and offerings, Jesus said, "As for these things that you see, the days will come when there will not be left here one stone upon another that will not be thrown down." And they asked him, "Teacher, when will these things be, and what will be the sign that these things are about to take place?" And Jesus said, "See that you're not led astray, for many will come in my name, saying, 'I am he,' and 'the time is at hand.' Do not go after them. And when you hear of wars and tumults, do not be terrified, for these things must first take place, but the end will not be at once." Then he said to them, "Nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be great earthquakes, and in various places famines and pestilences, and there will be terrors and great signs from heaven. But before all this, they will lay their hands on you and persecute you, delivering you up to the synagogues and prisons, and you will be brought before kings and governors for my name's sake. This will be your opportunity to bear witness. Settle it therefore in your minds not to meditate beforehand how to answer, for I will give you a mouth and wisdom which none of your adversaries will be able to withstand or contradict. You will be delivered up even by parents and brothers and relatives and friends, and some of you they will put to death. You will be hated by all for your name's sake. But not a hair of your head will perish. By your endurance, you will gain your lives. But when you see Jerusalem surrounded by armies, then know that its desolation has come near. Then let those who are in Judea flee to the mountains, and let those who are inside the city depart, and let not those who are out in the country enter it. For these are days of vengeance, to fulfill all that is written. Alas for women who are pregnant and for those who are nursing infants in those days, for there will be great distress upon the earth and wrath against this people. They will fall by the edge of the sword and be led captive among all nations, and Jerusalem will be trampled underfoot by the Gentiles until the times of the Gentiles are fulfilled. And there will be signs in sun and moon and stars, and on the earth distress of nations in perplexity because of the roaring of the sea and the waves. People fainting with fear and with foreboding of what is coming on the world, for the powers of the heavens will be shaken. And then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. Now, when these things begin to take place, straighten up and raise your heads, because your redemption is drawing near. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Having confessed the faith in the words of the baptismal liturgy, you can be seated as we continue with the song before the sermon, "Lead Me to the Cross."
Savior, I come, I quiet my soul, remember redemption's hill where your blood was spilled for my ransom. Oh, everything I once held dear, I count it all as loss, and lead me to the cross where your love poured out. Bring me to my knees, Lord, I lay me down. Rid me of myself, I belong to you. Oh, lead me, tempted and tried, human. The Word became flesh, bore my sin and death. Now you're risen, oh, and everything I once held dear, I count it all as lost. And lead me to the cross where your love poured out. Bring me to my knees, Lord, I lay me down. Rid me of myself, I belong to you. Oh, lead me. Lead me to your heart. 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 And lead me to the cross where your love poured out. Bring me to my knees, Lord, I lay me down. Rid me of myself, I belong to you.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the crucified and resurrected Lord. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah. The gospel lesson is the sermon text this morning. Luke chapter 21. Maybe by the numbers you can just tell we are drawing really close to the crucifixion and the resurrection at that point in Luke. Luke 21. Jesus is in Holy Week when he speaks these words. These words of reality, warning that everything in all of creation will be shaken except that which he has made permanent, his kingdom, his word, it will never be shaken or taken. But everything else, our bodies, our families, even the heavens will be shaken. The world will fall apart and the kingdom will remain. The first part of Luke chapter 21, though, is not read this morning. The first verses, and they include a story that we know pretty well. The story of the day that Jesus was sitting in the temple courts and watching people bring their offerings and place them in the offering box. Those who had a lot, well, some of them brought what seemed like a lot and placed it in the offering. And then one woman came, a widow, with two tiny copper coins, and those she placed in the box. And from a distance, not speaking to her, but about her, to his disciples, Jesus said, "This woman, out of her poverty, put in everything she had to live on." Everything she had to live on. Trusting God, who is trustworthy. We don't know much about her life, except that we know she's a widow. So the story must include that at one point in her life she was married. And it's not hard to imagine that on that day when she was married, hopes were high and confidence was strong. For many years maybe, the marriage was good and strong and there was great joy. And then he died. She was left alone. And I can imagine, only imagine, that it seemed like the world was falling apart. You know what that's like in various ways. Maybe you've buried
your spouse already, or a child, or parents, dear friends, and it can feel like the world is falling apart. And in a way it does. Jesus says, believe it or not, it's going to get worse. All of life will be shaken. But like that widow, like those disciples standing with Jesus and admiring this beautiful edifice of the temple, the kingdom remains. For those who trust in Christ alone, who live by their baptism, who live in repentant faith day in and day out, like that widow, we live by faith and not by bread or coins or bank accounts. We live by the word of God and the righteousness of Jesus that's been placed upon us. We live by it because Jesus is in Holy Week when he says these words, and he is just days away from the cross when he will be taken. And the world will be shaken, and the heavens will darken, and the earth will quake. And this is God's doing, that he is purchasing for himself, by of all things, suffering and the cross, a people for his own possession. People who are now defined not by the size of their bank accounts or the feelings in their heads. People who are defined by the cross and the empty tomb of Jesus. The world is falling apart. We see it more and more. And like Jesus says, amid the ruins, we're standing up and holding our heads high because our redemption is near. We live like that widow, not by the mites in our pockets, not by the beauty of the church that the disciples were admiring. We live by faith in the Son of God who is given for me, for you, and for all. We live by the triune God's sufficiency, the Redeemer's work, the King's rule and reign over us. Because he sought and he found, he bought and he redeemed and made us ready. The song we'll sing at the end of service this morning says, my worth is not in what I think I own, but is fixed by the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who put everything on the cross, who bought us with that. It is all we have to live on. And we find that his cross and his empty tomb is enough. And God's people say, amen. The peace of God, which surpasses understanding, keep our hearts and our minds safe in faith in Christ alone. Amen. We worship the Lord with our offerings. The things that we think we own, we only manage, and we gladly turn them back to him for use in his kingdom and for our neighbor's good. To the Lord, our offerings. Prayer of the Church is printed on pages 5 and 6. You'll want to follow along there because the psalm of the day is interwoven as our response to many of the petitions. Let us pray for the Church around the world, all people in their various circumstances, and ourselves as we all await our Lord's return
Oh, sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. Lord of the church, strengthen the resolve and increase the joy of clergy and lay leaders as they bear the good news of the marvelous things you have done through their efforts and the blessing of the Holy Spirit. Grant that many come to faith and rejoice on your return. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. In all the nations of the world, Heavenly Father, guide those who are in seats of authority. Give them wisdom to rule in compassion and justice and provide for the common good of all their citizens. He has remembered his steadfast love and faith. Heavenly Father, hear the prayers of those who are in ill health or sorrow or stresses of life. We name before you Nick Miller, Craig Wolf, Lori Mayberry, Zach Fritcher, Marion Tolch, Dave Wall, Vivian Kinkler, Rochelle Allwert, Ronnie Ziegler, Onda Wente, Bessie Booty, Erna Nickum, Diane Doty, Carolyn Reynolds, Ruth Buning, Bob Miller, and these who in silence we name. Bring your wholeness to them, that they return thanks and praise you. Make a joyful noise to the Lord all the earth. O Holy Spirit, giver of all good gifts, move musicians and poets, artists and actors to use their talents to praise your name. Confront the ills of society and inspire those who hear and see them to acts of love and good works. Let the sea roar and all that fills. Lord Jesus Christ, accompany all who travel on sea or land, in air or space. Give insight to those who must deal with changing weather. And provide for all who farm, transport, and distribute the bounty of your good creation. He will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with equity. We rejoice today at the birth, rebirth of Cohen Willenberg and ask you, Lord, to bless him and Kyle and Bailey as they lead in faith and repentance, joy and obedience. We pray in thanksgiving that you've partnered with us to feed those in Haiti, to show mercy as you've blessed us. And we ask you to bless Trinity Hope and our fundraiser today, that it would bring glory to you, and it would also bring mercy and Christian love to our neighbors. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Confident of your ordering of all things, we commend to you into your care all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The Lord has remembered his steadfast love and faithfulness. Break forth into joyous song and sing praises. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Oh, sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. We introduce to you a new hymn, My Worth is Not in What I Own. My worth is not in what I own, not in the strength of flesh and bone, but in the costly wounds of love at the cross. My worth is not in skill or name, in win or lose, in pride or shame, but in the blood of Christ that flowed at the cross.
I rejoice in my Redeemer, greatest treasure, wellspring of my soul. I will trust in him no other. My soul is satisfied in him alone. As summer flowers we fade and die, fame, youth, and beauty hurry by, but life eternal calls to us at the cross. I will not boast in wealth or might, or human wisdom's fleeting light, but I will boast in knowing Christ at the cross. Rejoice in my Redeemer, greatest treasure, wellspring of my soul. I will trust in him no other. My soul is satisfied in him alone. Wonders here that I confess, my worth and my unworthiness, my value fixed, my ransom paid at the cross. I rejoice in my Redeemer, greatest treasure, wellspring of my soul. I will trust in him no other. My soul is satisfied in him alone. I rejoice in my Redeemer, greatest treasure, wellspring of my soul. I will trust in him no other. My soul is satisfied in him alone.
Let us pray. Let us pray. Grant, Lord, that we would live by our baptism, that we would live in who you are and what you have accomplished at the cross. Grant us your grace as we go forth to live with confidence as you come again. And God's people say, Amen. Pass the peace of Christ to those who've worshiped with you. I'm going to shake my hand. Thank you, Lord.